Welcome back. So in today's video, I recently just bought a ColourPop palette collection. Well, collection. If you want to see what it is, just keep on watching. All right. So I ended up buying the High School Musical collection from ColourPop. It was an impulse buy. I didn't even look at what it brought. I didn't even see like what it looked like. I just went on browsing on TikTok all the time. I just went on their website just to see what's new, and I was like, oh, that's cool. So I just pretty much bought it. I think my cat is hungry. Alright, so I'm gonna just pull everything out and lay them in front of me, so that way there's three of these. I don't know what those are. I'm pretty sure this is the palette. I'm pretty sure that probably one of those things is either a highlighter or a blush. I'm not sure. If there's no highlighter in here, I'm gonna be very upset because I did not bring a highlighter upstairs. So, I'm getting rid of the box. I'm gonna pull up. I was watching TikTok. So, I'm gonna start off with these. This is a lip crayon. Don't make fun of how I'm saying crayon, because in my last video, I was saying scissors. And I remember getting like, not bullied, but like teased for the way that I say scissors. This is what this one looks like. This one is called Just a Tint. I don't know if that's actually, no. Okay, hold on. I don't know the name of it, but I'm gonna just swatch it really quick. That is this, that's actually really pretty. I'm gonna put that to the side. Let me see, Pop and Lock. That's what it's called, Pop and Lock. And then this one is Cello. Let me see if I can. Okay, so this one just seems a little bit darker, which is more of a red. This might be, yeah, it's a lip crayon. Why does this one seem more creamier than that one? Do you see the difference? Like, this one seems more glossy, because that's what it feels like. The other one didn't seem like, if you could look, you see it? This one looks more matte and this one looks more glossy. Maybe that's just the way that it is. Okay, and then I guess, oh, and then this is another one called Status Quo. It's always one of them that gives me a hard time. It's always one. All right, and now this one seems like a nude. See, that one seems like a nude. I'm gonna, that's what that one looks like. That actually might be a little too light for me. I don't know, we're gonna try it maybe later. I don't know what I'm doing yet. All right, those were the three of those. Just toss that to the side. And then they have three gel liners. It looks like there's a red, a white, and a gold. One is called Exit, Spring Musical, In This Together. So let's take a guess. What were the words? I feel like this might be Exit. Let's see. Ah, I was right, and I didn't even look because it was looking like this. They all came like this. They didn't come showing the name. All right, so this is Exit. In This Together, nope, Spring Musical, and then this one is In It Together. So In This Together, obviously we already know what their cream gel things look like. Do all of them at once so you could see that. I'm pretty sure there's other videos that like talk about this palette, and I'm pretty late to the game, most likely, but I don't care. I want to review it. So those are the three. So Exit, Spring Musical, and In This Together. So those are the three. I'm getting rid of that. All right, now these. I don't know what these are. I wonder if they're like, let me see. Oh, a pressed powder blush. Which one is this one in? Is this called like Wildcats? Yeah, this one is called Wildcats. Let's see what this, oh, it doesn't have like one of those little plastic things. So that's what that one looks. It has like a legit Wildcat. That's actually pretty cute. I don't know. That does not even show up on my skin. Let me see. That barely even shows up on my skin. So we'll see. All right, and next is, if I can get this open, another pressed powder, which is Playoffs. Don't tell me all of these are fucking pressed palettes. I mean, pressed blushes. All right, and then there's this one, which has little paw prints. I'm gonna put this. That's what that one looks like. So you can see the two right here. All right, and then this one is, let me get to it. Freaking Genius Girl. Okay, another press pack. I have jeans on and I hate wearing jeans, and I just got all of this all over my jeans. All right, so Freaking Genius Girl. All right, this one most likely will pop up on my skin a lot better. Let me see. Excuse me, Lunar, you need to get out. All right, and then there's that one. Okay, so then pretty much what's left is the palette itself, and they're starting to come in like this, which I don't understand that, because it doesn't really protect it. The plastic, like the bubble wrap does. This is what the palette looks like. There is 15 shadows, I believe. But oh, okay, so it comes sideways like this, I guess? Or is that just, oh, it actually does come sideways. And look, here goes that plastic thing I was looking for. This is what it looks like. I'm not sure if I even like it. Like, I'm not, I don't know. I wanna test this one out. I went straight for the green. I'm gonna go for the blue, which the green is Ryan, blue is Troy. Let's do Sharpay. Sharpay. All right, so those are what they look like. I'm not sure if they're even gonna look good. I'm not sure if they're even gonna look good. Sorry, I'm trying to like get caught. All right, well, we're gonna try this out. I didn't prepare anything because, look, I don't know if you can see Luna. Okay. So I really didn't prepare myself right now because my niece came over and it is her birthday. So she may make an appearance. I'm not sure, because right now I'm just trying to get all my shit out so I can get, because I have my little basket here that I carry everything upstairs with, because it is hot in my room during the summer. So whenever I'm doing my makeup or something, it just doesn't pan out, especially downstairs. I get very bothered from the heat, and I don't like the heat. My mom always says that I should live in Alaska or something, which I've never been there. I really do want to go though. That's one place that I want to go, and so is Europe. I want to go to Europe so bad. I looked up on like air tickets, so that way I can go and maybe start making a plan, because as I said before, I'm going for my master's in clinical psychology. So I want to, when I graduate, I want to actually take a trip. Like, I want to treat myself to go to Europe. I know everybody's like, oh, just go, don't wait. It's something that keeps me motivated to actually go, if that makes sense. So I really do want to go there. There's other places that I want to go to, but as of right now, those are like the two main places that I want to go. So hopefully at some point in my life, I get to go. I'm putting that in the universe. I want to go so bad.
Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to prime my eyes. I'm just going to use my Tarte Shape Tape.
I don't use any kind of special primer. I'm going to just do one eye at a time because if I don't like the way that it comes out, I don't want to have to start over completely. Okay, so I really don't know what I want to do. So you'll never guess what I did. I literally washed all my brushes and left them inside the little container. So hopefully we have some dry ones in here. Alright, I think I'm just going to use this brush for now. Because since I don't know what I'm doing, look, I cleaned this brush and there's still color on it. I think I'm just going to need to buy a whole new set of brushes. We'll see. Alright, so I kind of want to start with this shadow here, which is called Cream Blay. I don't fucking know. And of course, the palette does not have a mirror, so I have to grab my handy dandy mirror. And then I'm just going to go like this. This has glitter in this, and I'm not sure how I feel about that. Because that's not what I wanted, but it is what it is at this point. We're just gonna wing it and go from there. I don't know if you guys can see it. There's a little bit of glitter. And there's a lot of fallout. Not a fan of. I have the window open. Because it was actually nice this morning. Alright, so I think I'm gonna switch brushes now and I'm going to use. Let's keep my brushes here. Where's my other brush? I could have sworn I had my other brush over here. Where is it? Where's the little one? I guess I'll use this one. This was from the Michaela Pop 2 collection with Glam Light. So I'm going to use this and I'm going to take I don't know what shadows are going. I don't like any of these shadows together. I'm going to take this one, which is, what is that, a cell phone question mark. Okay, I'm going to take this much. Let's see how this goes. Because I just want to get that right here. Did that make a difference? I feel like it did not. I don't know. Maybe my eyesight is just going bad. I just wanted to use this brush just to get like a little bit of a dimension going on here. So I'm gonna leave it just like that. I'm gonna take my E2 brush and I'm gonna go into Scholastic de Califon, or whatever you wanna call this shit. You know what the fuck I'm saying. Listen, I'm sorry, but I curse a lot, so if you don't like this, then I think you should just go to a different video. All right, so. I don't know how I feel about this. These shadows are appearing a lot lighter than what it looks like in the pan. They're appearing a lot lighter.
because like that's the shadow right here, this one that I just put on the outer corner, and I don't know, that just seems a lot lighter. So I'm gonna try and grab a lot more like that, and I'm just going to dab it on. Maybe that will help it. Either that, or I'm gonna have to just go in with that last shadow, because I kind of wanted something a little bit darker, and that doesn't seem like it's getting there. So right now I'm just patting it on and like going in a circular motion, because I have a feeling like if I were to wipe, like do like the windshield wiper motion or any of that like blending in, I think it's gonna like fade away. So I think the best way to handle this shadow is just to pat it on like that, but it's like nothing is coming out. Like there's shadow there, but I'm not sure if I like that. So I think I'm going to take an E5 brush from Bling Brushes, and I'm gonna go in with this shadow right here. Now you guys saw what that looked like, right? This one right here. Yeah, that one is called Detention. So I'm gonna take that, and that's what that looks like. So I'm gonna pat some of it off, and I'm gonna just take it lightly. I'm not going too hard on it. I'm just going very light. I darkened it up a little bit, but okay, so I'm gonna go in with the brush that I had before, and I'm gonna just blend that out right there. So that shadow blends. So I'm gonna just go back in with the tension and just pat this right here. And then swipe a little bit so it blends in with the shadow that I put previously, like the shadow right there. So I'm just gonna tap a little bit more because I want it to be a little bit darker. Not too dark, but like dark enough. Okay. And I'm just blending those two together. I'm not sure how I'm liking this, but I think I'm going to use, I think I want to use this Sharpay color. I'm wearing black, so I know it would match fine. So I'm going to use this and tap it on. That's a pretty color. I was going to do a cut crease, but I kind of don't know why, but I just don't really see the purpose of using a cut crease when you can just like leave this side blank and just put it on. That's just me. I don't know. Maybe it's just, I don't really care too much. Okay, that's actually coming out pretty. Just bringing that down a little bit. And then I'm going to see if I can So I'm gonna take, I guess it was this brush, I believe. take that shadow one more time and just wipe on there along with this one. And then take more of that Sharpay color and calm down a little bit. Okay. I think it looks decent. I'm gonna take, let me see where's, I'm gonna take my, if I can grab it, E37 brush from Bling Brushes, because you know I live off of Bling Brushes. And I'm gonna just take a little bit of Sharpay and I'm just gonna come right here by tapping it on. I wanna tap first because I know if you swipe, it may come off a little bit. But it is applying nicely with a brush. So right now I'm just gonna do this to blend it in with the other color. And I'm not going in very hard, like I'm not pressing hard on my lid. I'm just gently tapping and swiping. Tapping and swiping. And that's it. So what I think I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this brush here and I'm just gonna like blend this out a little bit. Just so it doesn't look so harsh right there. Yeah, okay. So I don't know. I feel like this could have been a little bit brighter and a little bit more shimmery, whatever you want to call it. But I think I kind of like it. So I think I'm just going to actually take the darker shadow Detention and I think I'm just gonna bring it up just a little bit more and tap right here just because I just feel like it just doesn't look right with the other. And I'm gonna take Sharpay again and tap it on. Okay, so I think I'm gonna just leave it like this. I'm gonna go ahead and do the other side and then I'll come back to do the rest of my face with all the other stuff. So I will be right back. Okay, so I don't own the rights to this music. I have to say that so I can actually listen to music. So I already did the rest, like the rest, the two eyes. I wanted to go in with the Born This Way foundation. I did get a new shade, but I don't know if it's my actual shade. So I'm gonna try that because I wanna try that method where we put the bronzer here and then the blush and stuff. And I wanna try that method one more time to see if I actually like it. Yeah, I think it matches. All right, so I'm gonna wipe this off real quick because I'm going to, try and see if I can cover up my birthmark. You're supposed to, if you're gonna cover things, you need to let this dry out. And I don't know if this ever happens to anybody else. Why does this happen? I try to clean it and it doesn't clean. I'm gonna let that dry. Don't own the rights to this music. So I'm letting this dry While that does that, I'm going to take my bronzer that I have from Anastasia, and it's a cream bronzer in amber, I believe. Yeah. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my beauty blender and I'm just going to tap that on because I don't know any other way on how to apply this. So if you guys know, let me know, because I see all these people doing this and I don't know how to do it the way that they do. My niece is here. I'm just gonna leave that like that. And I don't own the rights to this song. I'm gonna have to say this every single new song because apparently it doesn't, like, it says copyright or something on there. So I always have to do that. I'm gonna take my cream bronzer, Cheek Kiss from Milani. Nice in the sweet moon name. Alright, I'm gonna just take my, I did it on the other side of my beauty blender, so I'm gonna put that there. I'm not gonna do the whole concealer method, like going under my eyes right now, because the last time I did that, it dried out, and it didn't do... Why did I do that? It didn't do what I needed it to do. So, I didn't do that. Now I'm gonna go in with the foundation on my finger and I'm just going to apply it that way. Take some from here. Apply it there. A lot goes a long way, so do not get haywire with that. I'm literally going in with dots. This is where all of it's at, but whatever. All right, so I'm gonna go in with my beauty blender and I'm just going to blend everything out. Alright, so now that I did that, I'm going to... Okay, so as you can see, my blush kind of somewhat sort of disappeared, and so did my bronzer. So that is something that I'm kind of like confused about. So I'm just going to take the rest of this, and once I get the hair out of the way, I know I've seen it. Did you guys see it? Alright, so I'm gonna just do this because I know that there's still bronzer on here. And I'm just gonna dab that. Alright. So I'm gonna do my concealer. See, like, I'm not understanding why that happens. You see all the gunk that is on there? I try not to put too much on. And then the setting powder that I'm going to use is from the Givenchy brand. It's the Prism Libre. I hope I'm saying that right. And I'm going to use a powder puff to put that on. One of these. Don't own the rights to this song. But yeah, so I'm just doing this. I just did the other side. Alright, so I'm gonna just take my powder puff. And I'm gonna take some of the excess off. I'm gonna go on my hand like this. So it looks like that. And I'm just pressing it in. I'm not letting it bake. Because apparently I've been doing it all wrong. So now the new thing is just to pat it inside, like pat it. And then I'm gonna do the same thing to the other side. Alright, so I'm just pressing this on. And then I'm going to go in now. A little bit more. So I'm gonna go in with one of these blushes. Oh, you know what? Man, you could tell that I've been out of it for a long time. I didn't even do the bottom of my lashes. Like the bottom of my stuff in general. So let's do that first. I'm gonna pause the music because, you know, it's starting to get a little bit loud in here and I don't wanna yell anymore. All right, so I'm going to just pretty much repeat what I did at the top to the bottom. I don't know how well the shimmer or whatever you wanna call this thing is gonna work out. So I'm gonna just take the remaining thing on my brush that I have here and I'm just gonna go on the bottom of my lashes. Just like this. Uh-huh. See, I didn't need to dip my brush in anymore because it's already on here. So you don't want to grab more and then it adds more. Like if you have it already on here, you can actually just build it up afterwards. So that's pretty much why. That's how I do it. I don't know about everybody else, but that's how I do it. And then, as you can see, I still have some on here. So I'm just going to continue to go on to the other side. And then, even if you like were to run out, you can grab a little bit more. But you don't need more since this is the bottom of your lash. You don't really need to fan it out too much. So I just actually brought it all the way. That came out a little much, but it's okay. Then I'm gonna take that little brush that I used to apply this shadow over here. I'm gonna see if I can get it on here. So that worked a little bit. I'm gonna just grab a little bit more. So this brush actually works very well with shadows and it gets really in close up to the waterline, and I really like that about this brush. It is again the E37 brush from Bling Brushes. I know I haven't really talked about them in a while, but that is that. And now I'm going to, all right, so I like to do my lashes and everything before I kind of do the like certain things on my face, so that way it gives it enough time to dry, so that way when I do my setting powder, like not my setting powder but like my setting spray, it doesn't wet my lashes, and then whenever I blink or like close my eyes to put the setting powder on, it kind of leaks over and we don't want that. So that's why I tend to do this before I finish the rest of my face, so that way it dries. So we're not, you know, having to do your makeup all over again when your lashes get everything else wet. Okay, so I don't know which blush I want to use. Let me see. I don't remember which one it was that obviously was not going to show up on my skin. All right, so obviously this one is not going to show up on my skin because it's way too light. It's going to like look like as if the shadow that I had put on previously. But I think I might go in with this pink since the fact that I have pink eyeshadow on. Okay, so this doesn't even have a shadow, like a mirror, and I'm sitting here like, ooh. All right, so putting that on. Is that even coming on? I'm like coating this. All Okay. Not sure how I like this blush, but you could see it here. All right, so let me do the other side. All right, so this is what the blush is looking like. I kind of like it, but then I kind of don't at the same time. I don't know if it's because of the brush, but like I've always used this brush and it always worked. Oh, and by the way, this is the F34 brush from Bling Brushes, and it is the from the red collection that Allie Dawson has. So I'm gonna put some up here. So I ordered some extensions from this company called Zella, and they're basically refusing to help me because my package says that it was delivered and it never was. Like, I can't find the package, and even the people at the office said that they never got anything. So I had contacted them and they were like that they can't help me because I never clicked for require signature. I didn't think I needed to because I ordered it another one before that. It was just the wrong size. So I didn't think I needed to. And like usually it would recommend that and it didn't. But yeah, so I didn't think I needed to because of the fact that I had ordered some before and they came and I ordered it with the same delivery company. So FedEx said that it was delivered and it never was. So now I'm on the verge of looking for it. And I put, they were like that they put a, we put a claim in and that the, hold on. And then I let Zella or whatever you want to call it know that it's not here. And they're like, oh, well, if my package was stolen, they can't do anything for me. And I was like, well, my package, I never said my package was stolen. I just said that it never came. And I wanted you to verify for me that if it said it was delivered on their part, because, you know, sometimes the delivery people would say that it was delivered by mistake and then they don't deliver it. And they were like, oh, well, we can't help you because you didn't ask for a signature when drop off. So you mean to tell me you can't help me if either someone stole it or it was lost? So I emailed them again and I am waiting for them to respond. Hold on. I put a lot of this on. And I'm starting to like this one so much better. It is from Milani Make It Last Original and it lasts for a very long time. So anyway, so I ended up contacting UPS and they were like that it was delivered. And I'm like, no, it was not. Like, it's not delivered. So I had to like do a whole effing claim. And then I'm thinking like, do I need to go to my bank and request a refund or something? Because they're not doing anything. And I spent a lot of money on these extensions. So I feel like I deserve my product, don't you think? So yeah, I don't know what's going on right now, but yeah, this is what the look is looking like. I do like the blush and I do like the palette. Oh, forgot about these. Maybe I should go with a whole pink. Let me see. They do feel nice. They go on nice and smooth. I feel like there's a piece of hair here somewhere, but I can't grab it. And I do like it. I think it brought all my look together, so I might actually keep it on. I'm not really a pink person, but here it is. I'm not really a pink person when it comes to lips, because I feel like I don't look right, but I'm gonna, hold on, I gotta do this, because I feel like there's something on here, but it's not working. All right, so overall, I do like the collection. I just don't know how I like the blush, and I don't even remember which one I used. Oh, it was Freaking Genius Girl. That was the blush that I used. And then the lip I used was Pop and Lock It. And that's what this one is. And yeah. So this would look really nice with some lashes, but I still cannot find my tweezers and my glue. Can't find that anywhere. And I don't have any. And I basically went to order some. And it's supposed to come tomorrow. So I kind of need that now, but that doesn't help. So I can't put lashes on right now. So I don't know. I'm going to probably go to Ulta a little bit later and maybe I could just buy it and, you know, get it over with. Because I wanted to use, where's those shit lashes? I wanted to put these on because I really like these, but I don't know how. I did bring this up, which is the Foscara Overnighter from Kiss, but I can't apply it without tweezers, so that's not really helpful. So I don't know. All right, but I do like this collection. I don't know if I like the palette, but I like it enough to keep it. So yeah, this is the end of the video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And
hold
I hope
on
you guys
like another it. Thing
forgot it came with some liquid gel liners, and I'm gonna use the white one. All right, so yeah, now this completes the look. Now I'm done. And I think it looks okay. I just think it's probably a little obnoxious right now because I'm not used to this, but I like it and I hope you do too. So if you have gotten this collection and did a look, comment down below. Let me know what you guys thought about it. But I kind of like it, and I'm not sure if I like the palette because I don't like the color scheme. The color scheme kind of throws me off a little bit. It does resemble High School Musical pretty much, but I'm not sure how I like the color scheme. But I think I'm going to use this again, and my niece is here, so I think I'm probably going to try and use this palette on her and see how we like it. But I don't know how I like it, but I like it enough to keep it, so I might have to just use it again and see how it goes. And I think it actually might have been also that I let my concealer sit a little bit too long on this side, because this side looks a lot more darker than this side does, but it still looks nice. I just think that this side came a little bit better than this side because I think I let this side concealer dry too fast. Not dry too fast, but like let it dry. Like I let it sit for a little bit, so it might have, you know, affected the way that the shadow went on. So, but other than that, like I said, I think I like this. I like the look. I have to just keep using the palette to see if it's just because of the, you know, concealer and stuff. So yeah, if you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you are not a subscriber, please subscribe and click the notification button down next to it to get all my future uploads. I should be back hopefully very soon with another look, because I did buy another palette and I can't wait to review it with you guys. So I will be back very soon, and have a good weekend. Bye.